Hello, 8th grade. I'm Mr. Rogers, and you are watching the video lecture for section 2-3 in our books. This is on ionic bonds. We are jumping ahead into chapter 2. So ionic bonds, how things bond together. Not to be confused with James Bond or covalent bonds. Today it's all about ionic bonds. So this first screen, don't write anything down. This is kind of the big ideas of the lesson today. And our lesson objectives are two things we want to be able to discuss and do at the end of the lesson. Explain the difference between atoms and ions, or how an atom becomes an ion, to be part by the way, and also how ionic bonds actually form. Those are two big goals of the day. So here we go. First one, what is an ionic bond? And an ionic bond happens when atoms gain or lose one or more electrons to another to form an ionic bond. So we're losing or gaining electrons, and that change in charge causes us to come together. So when they have that positive or negative charge, remember, going back to electricity, opposites attract, they want to attract to each other. So the reason they do this is atoms, they want to have that shell, that outermost shell they have, remember the energy shells, either completely filled up to 8, or they want to empty, so they go down to their next full one. One of those two scenarios. So to do that, they give away, they gain or lose the electrons to get that shell happy. And these ionic bonds, they tend to form between certain types of elements. This will be more about the periodic table of elements. But they tend to form between metals and nonmetals. So actually kind of opposite sides of the periodic table. And we'll look more closely at that here in the next few slides. So ions. What are ions? An ion happens when an atom that gains one or more electrons will have a negative charge. So an ion being positively charged or negatively charged, it depends on whether it gains or loses an electron. So if you gain electrons, you're going to have a negative charge. It's kind of weird. You gain electrons, you gain negative charges. Now the overall charge on the atom or ion is negative. On the opposite side of that, an atom that gains, I'm sorry, that loses one or more electrons will have a positive charge because now you have more positives than negatives. You've lost negative charges. And so the overall term then for atoms that gain or lose electrons is called an ion. They have a charge. So an ion is an atom that has a charge, has a positive or a negative charge. So those rules there are pretty big to think about, these first two. You gain electrons, now you're negative. You lose electrons, now you're positive. All right, so here are some rules. And with these rules, like life, without rules, there's chaos. So these rules help kind of govern how things work. When different things bond together. So I definitely would have these in your notes. Yes, put all of them down in your notes, and you'll be learning them quite shortly here. So these are very important ideas and rules you're going to have to use with the periodic table to figure out how atoms bond together. So I'm going to be taking and using this information in class. So this is very important stuff to have in your notes, because you'll be using it in class. And so how do we determine the type of ion? Well, again, different elements do different things. And metals will lose their valence electrons. They tend to have less than 4 valence electrons. So that big rule right there. Here's a big one. Highlight it. Underline it. Less than 4, they lose their electrons. So if you have 1, 2, or 3, again, these are valence electrons, the outermost, they're going to lose them. So the charge of the ion corresponds to the number of lost electrons or number of gained electrons. In this case, they're losing electrons. Now they have a positive charge. If I lose one electron, I have a plus 1 charge. If I lose 2 electrons, I have a plus 2 charge. So on the other side, we have these nonmetals. And nonmetals, again, they have 4 or more valence electrons, so they tend to gain electrons. So these guys tend to be the negative ions, produce negative ions. So again, that charge corresponds to how many they gain or lose. So if you gain 1 electron, now you have a negative 1 charge, or 1 negative charge. If I gain 2 electrons, now I have a negative 2 charge. Depends how many you gain or lose. And now that determines how they bond and how many atoms bond with each other also, which we'll get more to in the future. So real quick here, guys, I want to show you the periodic table of elements. We talk about where these metals and nonmetals are. Our metals start over here, and they kind of go all the way around. Here's our transition metals right here. But basically kind of cut through right there. This chunk, big, big chunk of the periodic table, those are your metals. So our nonmetals are over here in green, yellow, and orange. These are your nonmetals. So these tend to gain electrons, really, if they have 4 or more. So more the left side, they tend to lose. this far right side, they tend to gain electrons. So what's actually happening here? Well, what happens here, we have two Bohr diagrams, one of sodium and one for chlorine. And what happens here is this outermost shell, sodium's got that one valence electron. And chlorine, again, they want to get to 8. That magic number is 8. I don't have that written down. Write that down right now in your notes. You want to get to 8 valence electrons. That's the magic number. There, I said it nice and loud. Put that in your notes. I'll be checking for that when I look at your notes. So that one valence electron, this one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 valence electrons. And again, it wants to be happy at 8. It's most happy when it has, or stable when it has 8 valence electrons. So sodium will lose this electron and give it to chlorine. And now that means this electron shell is gone. Now the next shell is this one. It's full. It has 8. And so now chlorine's happy because it has 8 there. So now they're happy. And the way we would draw this, like with a dot diagram, is probably a simpler and easier way to do. We'll probably do it this way more often than we do with the Bohr model. So we're going to make the dot diagram. We just draw that one valence electron and draw the arrow. And I actually already drew it over there. They gave it to it. So now sodium is giving that electron to chlorine. So now it's happy. And this produces ionic bonds. Here's the whole that bond. We haven't even talked about bonds yet in this section here. So bonds actually form between these, because now they're oppositely charged. This would have a plus one charge. It's lost an electron. Chlorine would have a one negative charge. It's gained an electron. And again, opposites attract. So these opposite charges are going to pull each other together and create a bond between sodium and chlorine. So what's happening here, again, our positive chlorine, or positive sodium, excuse me, and our negative chlorine are going to combine together into one molecule to form an ionic bond of salt, NaCl. This would be table salt. So we have a metal bonding with a nonmetal to form that ionic bond. I think that's one of the things we had to write down. So metals and nonmetals coming together form these ionic bonds. So there's a lot going on. The biggest thing I can tell you guys is make sure you understand the rules for what gains or loses electrons, and be able to use that in class as we go forward. So 7th or 8th grade, actually. Thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you along the way.